interview and job search strategies at work. I'd like to thank everybody for listening to this podcast. What this podcast is about is helping individuals get an IT job, entry-level IT job. You work at Walmart, you work at McDonald's, you work anywhere, you work at sales, and you just want to get into IT. You don't know how, you're not really sure who to talk to or how to do it. Well, that's what we talk about in the podcast. That's really the whole idea about the podcast, is helping you, the individual, get a job in IT. Recently, somebody asked me, they said, how do they go about getting people and hiring them? What do they do? What are the processes like? So I'd like to kind of explain that a little bit. I know a little bit about it. And here we go. So typically what happens is a company, we're going to call it Acme. You know, you probably know the Looney Tunes. Watch Looney Tunes or Bugs Bunny on YouTube. And what happens is the company, Acme, we're going to call them Acme. What they do is they put aside 3 months' salary. In this case, they're looking for a help desk person. They're looking for an entry-level help desk individual, 0 to 2 years experience, and they're going to pay that person $2,000 a month, basically. That's what they want to pay the salary. That's kind of low, actually, but we'll say it's $2,000 a month. That's about $24,000 a month, a year, and it's about roughly a little more than $10 an hour. So we're going to just assume that, right? And what happens is the company says, okay, we want to pay them $2,000 a month, and what do we need to do then? Okay, well, we need at least 3 months of salary, and we need at least double that, right? So instead of it $2,000 a month, they're going to need $4,000 a month. So 4 times 3 is 12, so they're going to have $12,000 a month in their bank, their bank of whatever, right? So Acme goes out and they say, okay, Acme HR or hiring manager, whatever, right? So it's an IT operate. Let's say it's IT operations manager. So the IT operations manager is like, I have a lot of work here. I need another person. So what the IT operations manager says after the chief executive officer or the CIO or whatever says, okay, we can afford this, so go ahead and find one. So the IT operations manager says to, probably they have a local recruiter, maybe they have a company that they go through, and what they're doing is it's like an initial meeting. What they do is they go and say, okay, we're going to call this company whatever. You know, Roadrunner. So Acme tells Roadrunner, hey, Roadrunner company, I want a help desk individual and help desk administrator. Here's the skills I want them to have. I want them to have some Active Directory. I want them to have soft skills. I want them to have phone support. I want them to be nice, you know, and pleasant to customers, because they're going to be customer facing. Okay, that's what I want. I also want them to have 0 to 2 years experience, which means probably most likely it's a couple months. So if you've recently got a job and you work for, say, a call center, maybe say Transcom or Sitel, well, you're perfect because you fit 0 to 2 years. So that five weeks of training that you got paid for working at Sitel is perfect. Okay. So after that, Acme says to Roadrunner, okay, I need this. This is what I need. So what happens is Roadrunner goes out and they go maybe to Indeed, maybe they have Monster, maybe they have ZipRecruiter or whatever. Put all those criteria in, and they say, boom, we have 100 candidates, right? So what Roadrunner does is they go out and they call on these candidates, the help desk potential candidates, right? They go out and they call on them and say, hey, you're one of 100 people. You know, what do they usually say? They say like, we'd like to talk to you about the position, right? And we want to just get feedback and, you know, we have a position open and we just want to talk to you about it, see if you're the right fit, et cetera, right? So that goes on, right? And after that, so we have 100 people that Roadrunner gives now to Acme. Acme's like, okay, hey, thank you. Appreciate it. You know, I have 100 people. Wow, awesome. So Acme then says, okay, I need to dwindle these down. So probably be the IT operations manager who will go and say, okay, let me look at these 100 resumes or 100 people, right? These 100 candidates. And I'm going to dwindle it down to a manageable number, probably 10, 20, maybe usually 10. So we'll say 10 people. So Acme, the IT operations manager, says, okay, I'd like to interview these 10 people. So Roadrunner says, okay, great. We're going to go ahead and make it happen, Captain. So they bring in the 10 people, and the IT operations manager probably won't interview all 10, but they're going to interview quite a bit, right? And, you know, maybe five, right, for the same position. And so what happens is they have the interview, right? And Acme says, great. How did it go? The feedback is great. Acme says, you know, awesome. We love it, right? And that maybe they have 3 candidates, right, that they want to hire. But they're just not sure yet. So what they do is they bring in, they have another second round of interviews. So the second round of interviews is usually maybe it's more technical, or maybe it's more personable, personality traits, maybe behavior traits, something like that, right? So usually what happens is in the second round of the interview process, they're going to bring in more people from the team that they're actually going to be working with, right? So they kind of want to just see how this individual acts. How do they interact with other people? Because they're going to be working with them, right? So they want to make sure that this person, is a good fit for the company. Okay. So what happens is they dwindle down and they have one person that they want to hire, right? But they have those 3 people. So what they do is they send an offer to the one person. And it's almost like a contingent offer, right? And so the IT operations manager gets with the HR, and HR of Acme sends out a job offer. So it's like a document, right? And it says, like, you know, we're pleased to offer you, you know, this much money, right? Now, mind you, Acme has $2,000 in the bank, right? But of course, they want to make more money than that, right? So they might say, hey, we're going to pay this. We're going to offer you $1,500, right? Even though they plan for $2,000 a month. So, you know, what happens is they send an offer out at $1,500, and the person says no. So what they do is they say, oh, well, that person said no. Okay, well, and maybe they don't want to offer again. Maybe they don't want to counter offer. Maybe they want to pay him $1,500 and that's it. So they say, okay, we're not going to go with that person, right? So what happens is they send an offer letter to the second person that they interviewed, right? And that person accepts. And then, of course, what happens is HR works with them and gets them on board, and they hire a person. So usually that process from start to finish takes probably 50 days roughly from start to finish. So you figure you're going in from nothing. You know, you need another person to handle the workload. And that's usually, let's say, 2 months, right, process. So that stands to reason, because you probably see a lot of times, you probably see companies, like, it's January, and they won't hire until February, which is now. Well, that's because after the first of the year, people are like, hey, I'm out of here. I'm going to leave, you know, my job. And so the companies have just started to get, it's okay, well, we need more people ramping up. We need to prepare for the summer months. We need somebody now. And so what they do is they just calculate and say, okay, based on our target growth, we're going to need somebody. And that's why you see a lot of places hire usually probably in February. They usually hire in May and September. And those are usually the hiring times of the year. So, okay. You know, I really appreciate everybody listening to this podcast. Like I said, if you want to reach out to me, ask me any questions, maybe give me, you know, something you just want to know about IT, right? Hopefully I can answer it, right? If I can't, I can definitely find an answer out for you, job wise. You can send me a message on my Twitter. It's Gary McNeely IT, so that's my Twitter handle. Just send me a message over there, and I'll respond to your message. So, thanks everybody again for listening to this podcast, and have a great day.